Welcome to the Spring 2021 Commencement Ceremony for the Galen College of Nursing, Louisville Campus. Please welcome our Master of Ceremonies, Administrative Librarian Joe Price.
Good afternoon and welcome to these commencement exercises. We appreciate your joining us today, and it's my privilege and pleasure to be here with you myself. We will begin today with words from the Dean of the Louisville Campus of Galen College of Nursing. Here is Lisa Peake.
Thank you, Joe. Good afternoon, graduates, family, friends, and distinguished guests. Today has been the event that all of our graduates have been waiting for. These students have been engaged in serious studies and have successfully completed their final exams of their nursing courses to be here with us today. Many family members and friends have experienced secondhand the trials, tribulations, and tears these students have experienced during their nursing journey. Now, on behalf of Galen College of Nursing Board of Directors, faculty, and staff, I would like to welcome you to the 184th commencement of the Louisville Galen campus for our spring 2021 class. Now, I would like to introduce Dr. Joan Fry, our academic president, who will share a special message.
Congratulations, Galen graduates. We are so, so happy for you to have completed your studies in nursing education. Today, I have the honor to introduce our guest speaker to start these ceremonies. Lisa Frank is an award-winning documentary producer who oversees the planning, execution, and delivery of groundbreaking creative projects from feature-length films to short documentaries on global issues for students worldwide. She has spent the last 12 years in collaboration with photographer and filmmaker Carolyn Jones to produce the book, film, and website that comprise the American Nurse Project, as well as the feature documentary Defining Hope, which was broadcast on PBS stations nationwide most recently. The film that was shown was called In Case of Emergency, about the indispensable role of emergency nurses pre- and post-COVID pandemic. Ms. Frank is a theater major graduate from Northwestern University. Please help me to welcome Lisa Frank.
You did it! Congratulations, Galen College of Nursing students. I am so honored to be with you today and be among the first to congratulate you on this incredible accomplishment of completing your nursing school program. I am not a nurse. I don't think I could ever be a nurse. I don't think I could make it through the chemistry. But I am a documentary filmmaker, and I have spent the last decade, along with my partner, Carolyn Jones, traveling all across the country, meeting hundreds of nurses from all walks of life. And what I can tell you from that experience is that you have entered truly one of the most important professions in the world. It's one of the only jobs I can think of where every day you have a chance to impact somebody's life. And not just in a small way, you have a chance to impact the entire course of their health and their life. And you won't even realize it. You will go into the next patient's bed and the next room and care for the person that needs you. But that patient and that family will go home and they will remember you for the rest of their lives because of the way you cared for them and the way you got them through what was probably the hardest thing they've ever had to deal with in their life. And that is so healing. So I hope that you can go out into the world and remember that if you have a hard day, just think about every patient that you're getting a chance to interact with. You are making a huge impact that will have a ripple effect into their entire community. It's a truly wonderful thing to see, and it's so healing and so important for our country. So I want to thank you for entering this remarkable profession. And again, I just want to say congratulations. You've done it.
So it's my absolute pleasure to introduce our next guest speaker. Many of you may have heard of Dr. Carrico related to her dedication and efforts in fighting COVID-19. But Dr. Carrico began her career in her fight for advocacy long before COVID-19. Dr. Ruth Carrico has dedicated her entire life and her career to researching infectious diseases, improving healthcare outcomes, and serving her fellow nurses. Dr. Carrico is a testament of what nurses can be and what we can achieve. She has authored and co-authored numerous peer-reviewed articles and textbooks that are used by leaders in her field all over the world. Infectious disease and public health specialists look to Dr. Carrico's work for guidance. She is a true leader in her field. Not only does Dr. Carrico lead in infectious disease, she's also a mentor and a fierce advocate. She has advocated for changes for the most underserved and desperate populations. She has advocated for better for the nursing profession. She has worked hand in hand with your professional nursing association to advocate for nurses to give you, your community, and your future patients the best chance at positive outcomes. Many of you may have been fortunate enough to serve on the front lines with Dr. Carrico during COVID-19. I have been fortunate and blessed to serve with her and to call her a friend and a colleague in arms. She is a true leader in our field. She is what embodies what it means to be a nurse and what it means to serve. It is my absolute pleasure to announce our guest speaker, Dr. Ruth Carrico.
Thank you, Dr. Welch. It is a delight to be here. And I want to echo what the previous speakers have said in congratulating you on this achievement. You know, you've now entered the club, the group of people that over and over, I guess we're 19 years in a row now, that the general public has said that this is the profession, our profession, that the general public trusts the most. Now, this is not just a healthcare profession. This is all. That means that you have incredible power and incredible responsibility. And every day we have got to earn this trust over and over and over, because our promise, our covenant to our patient is that we are going to do the best that we can for them, not just one time, but every single encounter, every single day. Now, I know you may think, oh my gosh, I've just graduated. That's a lot to put on my shoulders. But it is a lot to put on your shoulders, that the first day that you walk out now after graduation, when you are a nurse, that you have graduated, you have met the requirements as you complete your state board exams, that you now are part of the workforce that is, as has been described previously, impacting every patient and their lives. So that is a lot of responsibility. And that means that you are going to need to start off your first day investing in yourself. So what I want to talk with you about just in these short minutes is making sure that you are thinking about what is it that I need to do to make sure that I'm doing the best that I can do every day. So I want to ask you to do just a few things for me. First of all, I want you to be relentless in your focus and your desire on personal education. As you start your first job, there are going to be many things that you don't know. You're going to encounter medication that you have never administered before. You're going to encounter a health condition that you are not familiar with. You're going to have patients that present new ways of interaction and engagement that sometimes you'll feel like you are just not well equipped for. This is part of our profession. Every day entering a field where continuous learning is a requirement, that what you need to know for tomorrow, you will need to start researching and reviewing and reading about today. So be committed to continuous professional improvement. This doesn't mean that you need to stay in school. This doesn't mean that you need to continue with another degree, although I'm certainly somebody that's going to be a proponent for that. But what it means is that you will need to identify ways that you can continue to learn every day, whether it's reading journals, watching videos, getting onto many of the learning management systems, consulting with your peers, other colleagues, but be committed to learning every day. Also, think about who you are as a person. That means you need to know yourself and you need to know your value systems. You're going to be confronted with taking care of patients and interacting with others that may be very different in their philosophies from you, maybe different in their religion or their politics or just in your general ethics. This doesn't mean that you will provide care for them in any lesser degree. That means that you need to understand yourself, what you value, and how then you relate to others, because you will need to relate to your patients. You may be convincing them to do something or encouraging them to do something that hurts or something that they don't want to do or some lifestyle change that they just don't feel that they are ready to make. So you're going to have to be able to somehow go to where that patient is. Now, I don't mean geographically, but I mean wherever they are in terms of their ability to make change or their ability to accept what they have to learn or what you have to tell them. So to make that happen, first you need to be comfortable with who you are, how you relate to others, and then your personal values. The third thing that I want to stress is that as you are in your profession, you may find that you are involved in an area of nursing practice that just isn't your thing. You say, you know, I started off in this area, but it's just not something that keeps me excited or wants me to learn more. So don't be afraid to make change. And I think that's one of the beautiful things about our profession, that there are so many opportunities that you can continue your professional growth by saying, all right, I've been in this one particular area for a period of time. Now there's something else that I want to learn. Don't be afraid to make change. Don't feel that you have to stay in a situation. And I encourage all of the students and my colleagues, if you ever wake up and you get ready for work and the first thought on your mind is, I don't want to go there. I don't want to work there. Then that needs to be the first motivation for you to start looking, and that you need change. And that you're going to do your best work when you are happy at work, when you feel that you are appreciated, when you feel that you're in a learning and a supportive environment. If you're not there, then please don't stay. That will be like handing you a rock and hoping that you'll swim, that you cannot be successful and you cannot thrive and grow in that type of environment. So make sure that you're investing in your future by making sure that the environment in which you work is one that is supportive of you. Now, when I say that, you know, please remember, it's not all about you, that you are going to have to be part of a team. And so if there are things that aren't going well, always think about, what is my role in making this successful, or what is my role in making this environment less than successful? And be willing to accept if you have a role in heading things down maybe a pathway that isn't the right pathway. It's never too late to stop and say, wait a minute, I need to change my approach. And that maybe changing your approach may change everything about your perception of that work environment. I think basically what I'm asking you to do is think about your work environment and think not only what you bring to that work environment, but what could you bring if your approach is a positive one, if your approach is one that's filled with an area of focus on the patient and how we can make sure that the patient outcomes are ideal. I think one of the last things that I'll ask for you to do is start now and find a mentor. find someone that you can ask questions of. I remember, you know, early in my career, there were so many things that I needed to learn. I worked in a very fast-paced environment, and I felt like that every second was a learning opportunity. And there was so much that I didn't know. And I went to someone that was a lot more experienced than I. And I said, I feel like I need somebody that I can ask questions of that maybe it's something somebody else would call a really stupid question. Or they would say, gosh, I can't believe that you graduated and you don't know that. I didn't need somebody to tell me that. I needed somebody to help me learn the answers. So I went to this person and said, I need somebody that's going to let me ask these questions, that's going to understand that I may not know it all, that may help me anticipate problems and will help me be the type of nurse that I want to be, that I'm trying to be. And I remember that that person was so not only excited that I asked for her help, but she turned out to be one of the most important people in my career because she did. She let me know when I did things well. She let me know when there were things that mistakes that I had made, or perhaps when I hadn't worked as well or done as good of a job as she might have done. And she had very high expectations. And that let me know right then that if I'm going to give my best to my patients, I need to be able to give my best to my patients. And I need somebody to help me do that and help me learn. I'd close then with just some reminders that as I grew up, my parents asked me as a child growing up in the family to do three things for them. And I want to leave you with these three ideas on top of the requests that I've made of you. But I think as you were going about all of these activities, please remember, give your best always. It may not be perfect, but if you are doing your best, then that will help you then continue to improve. Secondly, make sure that you're doing what is right. And that's not always easy. The right thing sometimes is the hardest thing to do, but that makes you true to your value system and enables you to look somebody square in the eye and defend then what your approach has been, that you have done your best and you have done what is right. And lastly, I want you to treat every patient as if it were somebody important to you. It may be the golden rule, you know, treat others like we want to be treated. But the idea is that not every patient is going to be a fan of yours. You're not going to be a fan of every one of your patients, that there are going to be some people that are very difficult to care for. There are going to be some coworkers that are very difficult to work with. But if you approach then every activity where you are treating other people with the same amount of respect and kindness and courtesy that you want, I tell you, you will find that at the end of the day, your work day is one that you can leave it behind and you can know that you have done your best and you can leave it behind and go home then to your family, to your other life, your non-work life, and do that without then considering about what may have been or what might have happened, that you're able then to find that balance that we all seek in giving so much to our patients at work and still being able to go home and be wife, mother, husband, spouse, partner, a daughter, a caregiver, all the many roles that we play. So again, I'm so excited for your achievements. Some of you, I'm sure I have met as part of our interactions in your clinical rotations. Others, I look forward to meeting at some point in the future because after all, we're now nurses together and we will be able to address what our communities need as long as we are working together. So I welcome you to this wonderful profession, and I hope that you have the experience that I have had, that every day I've been excited about what I do. I have never once wished that I had done something differently, and that makes me, I think, be able to lead not only a happy life while I'm at work, but then a happy life as I am doing all of the other things outside of work. And at the end of the day, I'm able to know that I've done my best. That's all I can ask for. And I end up then leaving with that peace that many of us wish that we were able to find at the end of a very long, hard day. So again, congratulations. Congratulations to Galen College of Nursing for producing yet another fine group of nurses.
Thank you, Dr. Carrico, for those wonderful remarks. We appreciate your sharing. We appreciate your experience, and we especially appreciate your sharing with us the wisdom that you've gained over the years. At each Galen commencement ceremony, we present several awards to individual students who have been chosen as deserving recipients by their classmates and faculty members. The first of those awards is the Dr. Marjorie Perrin Human Touch Award. It will be presented today by Kristen Blanford, a faculty member in Galen's licensed practical nursing program. Kristen Blanford.
Thank you, Joe. Dr. Marjorie Perrin was a dedicated nurse educator, co-founder of Galen College, and member of the board of directors until her death in 2011. The Marjorie Perrin Essence of Nursing Human Touch Award is presented to a graduating student from the day and evening PN programs. This award provides an opportunity to honor Dr. Perrin's legacy of nursing compassion and to recognize Galen nursing students who exemplify the essence of nursing. The recipient is nominated by classmates who choose a peer they feel most embodies the human touch in dealing with their patients and fellow nurses. The Human Touch Award for the Day PN program. This student is described as the student that goes above and beyond with all classmates. This student is always prepared. This student asks great questions when things aren't so clear and answers questions anytime someone asks. This student will be an amazing nurse no matter where they work. It is our pleasure to present this award to Kimberly Fox. The Human Touch Award for the Evening PN program. This student has been described as always willing to help no matter how dirty or difficult the job is. This student is willing to help fellow students to understand the concept or skill. This student has a lot of enthusiasm, compassion, and heart to help everyone around them. This student is considered the rock for the whole class. It is my pleasure to present this award to Jennifer Lopez.
Thank you, Kristen. Our next award is the Catherine Mershon Emerging Leader in Nursing Award. And here to present that award today is Dr. Melissa McNulty, who is a faculty member in Galen's program leading to the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Dr. McNulty.
Thank you, Joe. Catherine Mershon personifies a standard of excellence that places her among the top leaders in the nursing profession. She is co-founder of Galen College's nursing programs and currently serves as chair of the board of directors for Galen College of Nursing. Due to her reputation as a nursing leader and humanitarian, the Catherine Mershon Emerging Leadership in Nursing Award was created to recognize a graduating student from each of our RN programs who demonstrates the personal and professional qualities of leadership, resourcefulness, innovation, and excellence. The candidate is nominated for this award by both fellow classmates and faculty. For our first Emerging Leader Award, this student was described as a strong person who has taken this nursing journey very seriously. This student is always helping other classmates and is there when needed, no matter the time. Our recipient is a leader, go-getter, compassionate, and loves what they do. The student will be an excellent nurse and caregiver to everyone. It is our pleasure to present this Emerging Leader Award to Morgan Bullock. For our second Emerging Leader Award, this student was described as a leader. This student steps up during any class or clinical opportunity, exemplifies the virtue of a great nurse, supports all classmates, and pulls you up when you are down. This student is positive during difficult situations. It is our pleasure to present this Emerging Leader Award to Ruth Carey. For our third Emerging Leader Award, this student is described as always being in class and makes sure that they are prepared, demonstrates great leadership skills, and works with everyone in class. The student assists other classmates when they are struggling and models professionalism and is a model Galen student. It is our pleasure to present this Emerging Leader Award to Sarah Kraus. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. McNulty. Next, we will present the Dr. Tracy Ortelli Leadership in Nursing Award. And to present that award, here is Ariel Young, Associate Director of our program leading to the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Ariel Young.
Thank you, Joe. The Leadership in Nursing Award honors nationally recognized Dr. Tracy Ortelli, a leader in nursing education, role model, mentor, and scholar who has dedicated her professional career to advance the development and assessment of nursing curricula and the certification and recognition of nurse educators. Dr. Tracy Ortelli was instrumental in the initial development of the pre-licensure baccalaureate program for Galen College of Nursing. The Leadership in Nursing Award was created to recognize BSN students who demonstrate outstanding leadership qualities by inspiring others, exemplifying personal integrity, serving as a role model and advocate, and upholding Galen College of Nursing's ICARE principles of inclusivity, character, accountability, respect, and excellence. The recipients of this leadership award can be described by their classmates as motivating to keep everyone going, working hard in and out of the classroom. Other students will look to this individual for additional support and help, and the student is a leader and will make an excellent nurse. It is our pleasure to announce our recipient of this award to Victoria Durando. Congratulations.
Now, everyone, Galen College of Nursing is honored to share with you the names of those graduating today from all our programs. The names will be read by Emily Selch, director of our program leading to the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Emily Selch.
We will start today with our BSN graduates. Kennedy Abrams. Daniel Adams. Mina Adams. Chanel Atkins. Nicole Austin. Lauren Bladen. Sarah Brangers. Lindsay Browning. Kimberlyn Chan. Barbara Cravens. Tavani Crowders. Shakonda Daniel. Tiffany Devan. Victoria Dorado. Aaron Eggins. Tierra Eversley. Macy Foote. Lindsay Gardner. Tori Gillen. Christina Hardy. Kayla Hegstad. Allison Hinnan. Paige Hess. Stepniqua Johnson. Lauren Korn. Kayla McCarthy. Charmaine McLean. Jack McDowell. Emily Mercier. Sydney Milton. Lindsay Newton. Morgan Pace. Shelby Paul. Anna Rogers. Rebecca Smith. Tara Sowers. Leslie Sprague. Abigail Thomas. Kayla Thurman. Emily Travis. Darian Velez. Kendall White. Alexandra Wimsett. Caitlin Ray. Now our ADN graduates. Sarah Arnold. Caitlin Arthur. Kylie Ball. Teresa Bellin. Emily Billingsley. Kathy Bradshaw. Olivia Bramble. Tiffany Brown. Morgan Bullock. Andrea Burke. Ruth Carey. Harold Charles. Crystal Conan. Sherry Cooper. Haley Craig. Stacy Cranmer. Brittany DeLay. Mary DeWitt. Catherine Dewan. Louisa Diaz Smith. Natasha Doolin. Rodney Fields. Susan Fisher Blackburn. Donna George. Heather Gibson. Michelle Gore. Tabitha Haste. DeMarcus Hayden. Jacqueline Higdon. Skylar Hunter. Kayla Keeping. Audrey Keller. Sarah Krause. Tyler Kuhn. Ashley Lee. Kristen Mansell. Lindsay McDonald. Hannah Miller. Margaret Mills. Olivia Mullins. Jamie Aller. Libby Paradise. Bethany Pruitt. Haley Ratterman Herod. Daniel Rainier. Paulina Roberson. Kiersey Rogers. Lindsay Schuler. Stephanie Skaggs. Crystal Sobers. Shalonda Stark. Nicole Sullivan. Adrian Thompson. Jordan Turner. Elise Whiting. Alexis Williams. Morgan Wilson. Autumn Yoakum. Rachel Young. Ashley Zaniser. Now for our PN graduates. Cynthia Abaka Uwisi. Misty Beard. Taylor Bennett. Lankia Blakely. Jessica Brockman. Amy Cisse. Mary Daugherty. Mara Aballer. Eleni Ferriol. Kimberly Fox. Ashley Galliano. Taylor Gillick. Amy Gosnell. Brittany Grant. Caitlin Howard. Emily Johnson. Rita Johnson. Alexandria Cannenberg. Brittany Kendrick. Deidre Lane. Jennifer Lopez. Jopa McDonald. Rachel Munn. Kelsey Poteet. Amber Price. Omotola Tugunde. Krista Toole. Heather Uhl. Devante Urbina.
Thank you, Emily. It's especially gratifying to hear those names and to think of the effort and determination and the sacrifice that our students have put into the pursuit of lifelong dreams or better careers or a commitment to service to other people. And I want to say that to have the opportunity to be associated with people like our graduates who have chosen to get the education and the practical experience required to go to the front lines of nursing is an honor and a privilege for the faculty and staff of Galen College of Nursing. Thank you. Here now to lead the ceremony of lights and the nursing pledge is Linda Bragg, who is a faculty member in Galen's programs leading to the associate degree in nursing and the Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree. Linda Bragg.
Thank you, Joe. So the ceremony of lights. We have a tradition in nursing education. It's called the ceremony of lights. Through the ceremony of lights, the passing of one flame to another signifies the passing of knowledge and the acceptance of the responsibilities and the rights and obligations of the nursing profession. We offer our pledge in this ceremony. So Florence Nightingale was a British nurse and social reformer born in 1820. She became one of the most prominent figures of nursing in the 19th century. Her work profoundly affected policies and proper patient care. She demonstrated that well-trained nurses and attention to sanitation and cleanliness in hospitals helped people who were sick get better. The Nightingale Pledge, named in Florence Nightingale's honor, is a statement of the ethics and principles of the nursing profession. Today's pledge is a modern adaptation of this pledge. It was originally written in 1893 by a committee led by Lestra Gator. She was the principal of nursing school in Detroit. They considered their statement a modified version of the Hippocratic Oath used by the medical profession. So at this time, I ask that each of you stand at home and recite the pledge with me. I solemnly pledge myself in the presence of this assembly to practice my profession with integrity. I will endeavor to maintain and elevate nursing standards both as a science and art. I wholeheartedly recognize the importance of quality standards of care and of personal accountability. I will devote myself to the protection, the healing, and the welfare of those committed to my care. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and will respect the privacy of medical information. I accept a duty to work for the improvement of health in the communities in which I live and work. I will act with compassion in ethical matters. I will not take or knowingly administer any harmful substance. I commit to interdisciplinary collaboration and lifelong learning. I fully acknowledge the seriousness of responsibility integral to the nursing profession and the significance of commitments I pledge today. Thank you.
Linda, thank you. And now, everyone, we have a treat for you, a couple of treats, actually. First, a video thank you. This is a love note, if you will, from the Kentucky Nurses Association. And then a few words from some folks that I think our graduates will recognize. Thank you for being with us today, and please enjoy this next part.
In a time full of war, be peace. In a time full of doubt, just believe. Yeah, there ain't that much difference between you and me. In a time full of war, be peace. In a world full of hate, be a light. When you do somebody wrong, that needs change and make a difference. In a time full of noise, just listen. Line is 6 feet in the ground. In a race you can't win, just slow it down. In a world full of hate, be a light. Oh, when you do somebody wrong, make it right. Make it right. Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate, be a light. In a world full of hate, be a light.
What's up, Galen College of Nursing on the Louisville campus? It's Nurse Blake, and I just want to say congratulations to each and every one of you for making it to the finish line. You guys are graduating. That is such a huge accomplishment. You should be so proud of yourself. I know your faculty is so proud of you. They were the ones that reached out to me. I'm so proud of you. This is so exciting because listen, nursing school is not easy. It is difficult and challenging, and you're studying all day and all night for lab, clinical, lecture, exam. But you guys did it. You stuck with it. And now you guys are freaking nurses. So now you could go out there and care for the patients and families in your community. So once again, a congratulations. You guys did it.
Hey graduates, it's Joe Price from the library. Best wishes, congratulations. Please remember me when I meet you in the hospital. Thanks.
This is Amber Moore, assistant professor. I just want to say congratulations to all the new grads. Don't forget about your Galen family and just always remember you got this.
Hi graduates, this is Brian DeVore, the associate program director for the ADN program. And I want to take this opportunity to congratulate you on a job well done. You guys have managed a very difficult program and have reached your goal and dream of graduation. So again, congratulations. I wish you the best of luck now and in the future. And you all will make great, great nurses. So again, congratulations and good luck.
Hello. I would like to congratulate you on completing your course requirements and graduating with your nursing degree. My name is Deshonda Stanton, and I am the Clinical Learning Lab Coordinator and Associate Professor at the Kentucky campus. And I hope you put those skills to use and continue to promote the profession of nursing. Again, congratulations.
Hi everyone, it's Miss Spencer from the PN program, and here you are, your hard work has paid off and you've done it. So congratulations, I'm very proud of each and every one of you, and I hope to see you again soon in the RN program.
Hello graduates, it's me, Brittany Payne, one of your nursing instructors. I am so proud of each and every one of you. You've worked so hard and came so far. You will soon realize that nursing is the most rewarding and honorable job, just as I am honored as being your nursing instructor and helping you achieve your dreams. Please always have passion in your hearts, passion to serve and care and give to each and every one of your patients. I will miss you so much, and good luck on all your future endeavors. Go out and show them what you're made of.
Hi, Galen graduates. This is Karen Schuckman, one of your faculty members. I just wanted to say I'm so proud of you and congratulations. You guys are going to go on to do great things, and I'm proud to have been one of your teachers. Good luck.
Hi, Galen grads. Lauren Rosas here. I am so proud of you all, and I wish you guys the best of luck.
Hello, graduates. This is Shalonda Arnold, a clinical instructor here with Galen. And I just want to say I'm so proud of each and every one of you all. You have worked really hard to get to this point in your career. And I can't wait to see what the next chapter holds for each and every one of you all. Again, a job well done. Congratulations.
Charlotte Morton, ADN, BSN faculty. Congratulations to each of you all as you continue to move forward in the world of nursing as a Galen graduate.
Hello, graduates. This is Linda Reeder, and I am an assistant professor at Galen, and you probably have me in 170. I do want to extend my congratulations to you and much luck in your future as a nurse, and just be safe out there. Congratulations.
Hi, this is Sarah Kurowski with the ADN faculty. I just want to tell all my students, congratulations. You made it. You did it. Welcome to nursing.
Hello, my name is Tonya Newton, MSN RDN. I am so proud of each and every one of you all. You did it. Congratulations.
Charlotte Davidson, NUR, 155 instructor, Hazard, Kentucky. You guys finally made it. Congratulations.
Laura Lee, clinical instructor. Congratulations, graduates. I wish you the best as you use your passion, knowledge, and skills to change the lives of many.
Hello, everyone. This is Marshall from the operations side. I just wanted to say congratulations to our Galen graduates. You guys have been through a lot, and I just wanted to say congratulations and go forth and make us proud.
Congratulations, graduating nurses of 2020. My name's Marion Knight. I am the admissions manager. Most of my job entails getting to see you get started, all the excitement in the beginning, but the most rewarding part is seeing you cross this finish line. So I admire you so much and wish you the very best. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Galen graduates. This is Dr. Tracy Ortelli, Executive Vice President for Teaching and Learning Innovation, and I just want to take a moment and say congratulations. Getting through nursing school is no easy task, especially during a pandemic. And if there ever was a time that we needed nurses, boy, is that time right now. It is so inspiring to think about all that you will accomplish and the lives that each and every one of you will touch. Welcome to the profession.
Just want to say for all the students who had awards presented to them earlier in the program that in the next several days you will be contacted by someone on picking up those awards. So now, all spring 2021 graduates, please say thank you to your family and friends and give them an applause for their support, love, and confidence in your nursing journey. Upon recommendation of the faculty and by the Board of Directors, I confer upon each of you the respected academic degree for which you have been recommended, with all the rights, privileges, responsibilities, and obligations appertaining thereunto. You may move your tassel from the right to left, signifying completion of this step in your academic journey. Congratulations, you are now an alumni of Galen College of Nursing. Congratulations.